What is truth worth? Like, what do we think reality is worth? Is it worth a certain amount of money, and beyond that, it's a free-for-all and we should allow an environment of lies and fake news and mistruths and anti-science? That's not how a civilized society survives. It is absolutely not how it thrives.
As a university student, what you're here to do is to learn to think, really. And so all of the assessments that we're trying to provide you with are ways for you to take all of the information that's available in all the different ways. So some of that will come from Gen AI, some will come from peer-reviewed literature, some will come from colleagues, some will come from teachers, is to be able to take all of that information and assess it and critically think about it in a way that I understand it and that I can then explain it to other people.
Critical thinking is one of the great phrases of the modern era, and it was an important and difficult and problematic and inspirational phrase before this latest rise of AI, and now it's only more so. And the question really is, you know, what is it for, and how do we do it?
You know, we are often so fast to consume images, whereas I think there is possibly a part where critical thinking comes into play that actually can encourage us to slow down and think about what it is that we are seeing and observing.
When it comes to critical thinking, what question are they asking? And then question the likely sources, where those inputs have come from, who's framed that information in the first place.
It has never been more important for students to be able to critically analyse text and information, given the scale of the internet, fake news, and generally what happens in the public now. We are bombarded.
And not all information on the internet is true. Use it as a part of your creation.
One of the issues that students sometimes have using generative AI is they don't necessarily have enough background information to know whether the generative AI is hallucinating or not. It gives information that it thinks is plausible, but it's not necessarily true.
Critical thinking is, it's human. And it's about wanting to know, for a start, because we do live in a world where a lot of people are saying, no thanks, I don't want to know, I like the lie. In fact, I saw that lie has been disproved, but I'm going to lean in anyway because it makes me feel comfortable. That's my tribe, that lie. You have to want to know the truth.
Question everything you read. Try and find multiple sources to verify what you are reading. There is no shortage of information online on any subject, but it can take more time to carefully, critically analyse.
One of the most important things I want you to consider, especially as a new student coming into the university environment, is this. I really don't care what you think about anything, and I'm honestly surprised that you do care what you think. How about this? Tell me what you know. You have access, without AI, without social media platforms, you have access to the entire history of knowledge in the world in your pocket. Why don't we normalize that? Tell me what you know.
I think it's easy to blame the tool. It's easy to say, look, Midjourney stole from 1 million people. But I actually think that if you actually form a student well enough with good creative values, they on their own accord are going to question these things. They're going to say, why am I doing what I'm doing and using this to create this creative artifact? And what value does it have, not just to myself, but to society?
But it is important to remember that critical thinking is a muscle that you must exercise. And like all exercise, when we'd rather be lying in bed with a cup of coffee scrolling on our phones, you've got to want to get your ass up and into it.